Welcome, Professor Banerjee.
Thank you.
So this was your joint recommendation with Dr. Rajan, or this was your personal
recommendation? This was this particular view. I don't think we actually, with Raghu, I think what we said was not so specific about the numbers.
Amount. Okay.
It was more about, you know, what the objectives and style of the project should
so
be.
So there is some amount of bravado involved in here by with the Congress saying that if BJP can give you 6,000 in a year, we'll give you 6,000 every month, and economics we'll figure out later.
This bravado, there is also, I do think that at some point we'll have to bite the bullet. That's what I was trying to say, that we are a middle income country now, a lower middle income country, but definitely a country where the kind of desperate poverty that we have seems unacceptable. I mean, I work on the very poor, and I have seen this a lot firsthand, and people live in conditions which should not be acceptable to any of us.
What else did the Congress want to know from you as an economist?
What's the income distribution? Where's the cutoffs? Where are people, you know, if we set the, what, where we should we set the poverty line? You know, how many people are below certain levels? So that those kinds of numbers, that's I think the place where we mostly contributed, is by just being, trying to provide numbers where there aren't any very good numbers, thanks to our very broken data collection apparatus.
And how did you recommend, or how do you reckon this is going to be implemented, for instance, from here on? Let's say the announcement is, let's say they do come to power and do have, they've already announced. How do you reckon this is going to be implemented?
So I'm guessing that there'll be a couple of steps. One is based on the SECC, they're going to try to define a set of exclusion criteria.
Sure.
You know, if you have a car, you're not eligible. If you have a pakka house in a city, or even in a large village, you're not eligible, etc., etc. And from that, they're going to try to see how many people they exclude by doing that. And the first year, they're only aiming for the poorest of the poor, who are actually relatively easy to target. The easiest people to target are the people who are at the very bottom, because they live on outside villages. They often live in specific hamlets for, you know, the Jadavs or some,
yeah,
you know, discriminated community. So it's relatively easy to identify them. So I think a combination of geography, the SECC, etc., will give them a reasonably good guess at who these people are. It won't be perfect. And I think one thing I've been recommending over and over is that you can't be dogmatic about it, and you have to allow a scope for the community. When the community comes back and says, no, Rajeev is somebody who really needs to be included, you have to include him. You can't be, you say, no, our numbers say he's just above the line, is not good. And I think you have to have the attitude that you'll, if you aim for 10%, you'll go and get 12%, but that's okay. I think that is the right way to do it, but I don't think it's that hard. It's the next step will be harder. And I think for that, probably they need to update the SECC.
That's almost 9 years old now.
Yeah, which is 8 or 9 years old, and it needs to be updated. So the second tranche, the 10 to 20%, that gets harder, because they are a little less distinguishable from the rest. The bottom 10% are actually the most distinguishable people.
The most difficult part, it seems, is also to identify that 12,000 rupees, who's the one who's going to be eligible at that level? How does that equation work out?
Well, I think the way it's going to be done is through some predictive model. You're going to say that, look, if you have this, and this, you
then
are above.
Okay.
And you're going to have some exclusion criteria, and then you're going to impose some rule which says that, you know, anybody who doesn't have any of these things starts by being eligible, and then we might do a check on them. We might check that they don't have a government job. You know, I think they'll evolve a set of criteria. It's going to be, at the beginning, there's going to be a lot of problems, like with everything else in India. Every experience has been that. I'm not that worried about it. I think it's with the political will, and I think there will be political will. This is a kind of demand that doesn't easily, you can't make it and not deliver. One good thing about an ambitious claim is that you can't do this and not deliver. If you don't deliver, I think you are dead. So I think they will deliver, they'll figure it out. I mean, I'm not too worried about it.
So you think, do you get a sense that the Congress has announced it, and now they will figure out the fiscal space. There is obviously no fiscal space for something like this. What was the amount that 2,500 would have amounted to for the
30,000, so that would have amount, if you gave 2,500 to the bottom 10%, I think, I don't remember.
Would have been less than half of this amount, so about 1.8, yeah. More manageable. But this is, as the Congress says, so do you get a sense that, what is the architecture, how will this be implemented? Do you get a sense of that?
No, I don't know, I don't get a sense of that. I want to say that even without this, I think we are in a fiscally unsustainable state. So some major taxation reform has to happen. Whichever government wins, they will have to do. I mean, we have the banking sector that needs bailed out. You know, there's a whole bunch of things that need to be done.